It's Joe's first day at work. First days suck, right? What if he forgets his new password and is too mortified to tell his manager, who he met 9 minutes ago, because he literally created said password in front of said manager 8 minutes ago, all while making sure he employed enough dollar signs and at symbols to create an eligible password in the first place. So Joe spends his morning pretending to type at the login screen and praying that this furrowed-faced manager wasn't embellishing when he said he had back-to-backs all morning and couldn't check in on, you know, the guy on his first day. Joe wants to be invisible for a little while, maybe just a month or so, until he gets to know the lay of the land, the natural order of things, or at least where the bathroom is. Then when the time is right, Joe can make his big move. A choreographed kitchen encounter with that slovenly yet staggeringly self-assured co-worker, so Joe can utter his first words since stepping inside the building. That looks like a strong tea. Nailed it. Composed, Joe has passed the first stage of the unspoken squid game that is corporate office culture. And he could fit right in with the other survivors. Okay, maybe that wasn't exactly our Joe's experience, but the odds of a seamless onboarding, they were heavily stacked against him. In fact, he's one of the few in his demographic who even gets through the pre-screening. You see, society has told Joe that he has barriers to obtaining and remaining in employment. He's 23 years old, young enough to not have any experience, but old enough to know he needs it. He doesn't have formal qualifications, smart enough to sense companies value someone who's studied, and astute enough to understand how often it's a waste of time. Oh, and he's autistic. It's safe to say that on his first day, Joe's a little bloody anxious. In the last 2 years, I've employed more than 100 young autistic adults like Joe. We've trained them to be data analysts so they can conduct highly valuable services for highly valuable corporations. We've built a data analytics business from scratch, and it's growing at 200% a quarter. How can we do this? Because autistic minds are primed to become the rock stars of our big data economy. Well, that's my goal anyway. In the new economy, this goal should be easy to achieve. Many people on the spectrum are predisposed to be strong performers in data-driven roles. You see, autistic people are more likely to recognize patterns, retain information, and concentrate for long periods compared to neurotypical bumblers like me. I was a well-paid data analyst for 8 years in the corporate world, and I observed time and again how me and my team struggled to interpret complex problems in lateral or creative ways. Then I was recruited into my first executive role at a company that helped people with disability find work. I was head of business intelligence, whatever that actually means. But I did notice that we couldn't secure employment for our autistic job seekers. Apparently, some weren't keen on mowing lawns or folding sheets. So I decided to leave this plum position and run a new startup, a professional data services business that has the potential to employ 1,000 young adults across the country. Now every day I refuse to let the cognitive talents of autistic people go to waste. 70% of my team live with autism spectrum disorder. Now they are mowing through metrics and folding spreadsheets faster than Superman on laundry day. Even with a decade of data analysis under my belt, I couldn't keep up, or I can't keep up, with the young champions with whom I work every day. When it comes to data, they leave me in the dust. And the good news is the timing couldn't be better. Data analysts are some of the most in-demand professionals in the world right now, as almost every job requires data or systems knowledge. Digital transformations and data migrations are now the sexy programs in business and government. I'm not sure how that happened. But executives assign eye-watering budgets to these programs to modernize their businesses, increase productivity, and grasp for trends in this volatile economy. So why are these same executives systematically failing to snuffle up the millions of Joes out there who are so suited to these crucial roles in their companies? Because bloody society has put a few obstacles in the way. The common understanding is autistic people are hard to work with because of social and communicative deficits, which create learning difficulties, isolation, and ultimately poor performance. For the HR professionals watching, I have a news flash. This is bullshit. Take it from me, people on the spectrum can not only be star performers, but they can also be fun, fiercely loyal, and rally around a common purpose. Isn't that everything you want in a team? In case you need convincing, allow me to do some myth-busting. Here's our team being social and communicative at after knockoffs at the pub. Revolutionary stuff there. At lunchtime, trivia. Now, admittedly, the special subject was Star Trek. Each their own. And at a gala awards night. And here's our team working together on complex data projects in our office. Now, I confess, we invest in our people. We mentor, upskill, and do those team building and celebration activities to show we value each and every individual's efforts and idiosyncrasies. And that's what every other high-performing company does too. The difference is we have the autistic algorithm, and it's mighty productive. I strongly believe it's neurotypical people like myself who hold the deficits in understanding. We don't understand the common traits of autism. We think we do, but we don't. We're nervous about managing these characteristics, and we certainly don't know how to go and seek out diverse talent. And the ramifications of these perceptions are diabolical for our autistic community. In Australia, the labour force participation rate for people on the spectrum is less than 41%, and they are at least six times more likely to be unemployed than people without a disability. With autism spectrum disorder the fastest growing disability in the Western world, we need to do something now. My solution is to prepare them to become the rock stars of our big data economy. Join me, please join me, because it makes good business sense. Send a note to your HR to see if your company has an autism talent program. When advertising your next tech vacancy, include the line, "Neurodiverse candidates are highly encouraged to apply." Some action to improve work culture and productivity at your company, because diversity doesn't cost, it pays. Joe's been working with us for more than 2 years now. He's been promoted twice and is now a lead consultant working on infrastructure design for ASX 100 listed clients. He's happy leading a team of eight, and he's moved out of home. He's taken up cycling, for God's sake. Maybe golf will be next. Maybe he'll be leading data programs at your company soon. The Dave Grohl of data. The Bon Jovi of business intelligence. All I know for certain is he's already a rock star.